Senators disputed President Rodrigo Duterte's statement that congressional hearings are merely meant for posturing. In a public address Thursday night, Duterte urged the public not to believe in the Senate investigations because nothing comes out from these probes anyway.
Pakinggan mo yung mga ibang senador dyan, meron talaga masabi. After an investigation, 1 or 2 or 3 days, you hearing, wala na. Walang rekomendasyon, walang dinimanda, walang napriso. Puro postura lang, question.
Senate President Vicente Soto III reminds the president that most of his appointed officers are now facing charges because of the Senate's investigation on PhilHealth. Senator Richard Gordon, the chair of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, asserts their inquiries had led to the conviction of various high-ranking officials, including former immigration officials Al Argusino and Michael Robles. He adds, various officials from the Bureau of Customs were also removed from their posts after the Senate investigated the alleged illegal drugs importation.
Mr. President, konting respeto rin naman po. We respect you, I respect you, because you're the President of the Philippines. I always respect the title, Mr. President, and the man. Pero huwag naman ho tayo magsasalita sa co-equal branch of government na hindi ginagawa ang trabaho nila. Sapagkat napakahalaga po niyan.
Senator Panfilo Lacson, meanwhile, tells the president to mind his own executive branch, which he describes as incompetent and corrupt.
Kaya naman hindi nakakasuhan yung ilang matataas na opisyal na naging subject sa pag-imbisiga namin, eh dahil pinagtatanggol niya sa halip na makasuhan. Hindi naman trabaho ng Senado na magsampa ng demanda, hindi ba? Ang executive branch, yun lang magsasampa ng demanda.
Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon insists the Senate should continue doing its investigations.
Kaya tuloy lang po tayo. Halongkating natin ang mga dapat malaman ng taong bayan. It is our responsibility as duly elected representatives of the people to unearth truths, especially concerning disbursements of public funds.
Meanwhile, Duterte also vowed to audit the whole government if he wins as vice president in the 2022 national elections. This despite the fact that Duterte has not yet made public his own statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth, or SALIN.
I will do that if I become vice president. Ako na lang rin ang mag-audit sa lahat ng gobyerno. Lahat. Pati yung akin. Mag-umpisa ako sa akin.
He also told the public that he will never fool them.
Ako yung pinakahuling taong manluko sa inyo.
Something a lawmaker found laughable.
Eh di ba sa kanya na mismo nagsabi na bakit siya pinaniwalaan ng mga bumoto sa kanya at tinawag niya estupido?
Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.